Assalamualaikum students, today we will talk about the submandibular ganglion. As you all know, the submandibular ganglion is a peripheral parasympathetic ganglion that is concerned with the skeletomotor supply to the submandibular and the sublingual salivary glands. Now the topographically the submandibular ganglion is related to the lingual nerve. Topographically means that the fibers of the lingual nerve do not relay here, they just provide support and they just suspend the ganglion from the lingual nerve. Okay, the functionally submandibular ganglion is related to the caudal tympani branch of the facial nerve, which means that the fibers of the caudal tympani branch of the facial nerve relay here. Only the fibers of the caudal tympani branch. Now, let's talk about the skeletomotor supply to the submandibular salivary gland. Skeletomotor supply. You have to remember one thing, that the skeletomotor supply to the submandibular and sublingual salivary gland come from the superior salivatory nucleus. Superior salivatory nucleus, which is located in the pons. Superior salivatory nucleus. From the superior salivatory nucleus, fibers enter the nervous intermedius. Now, what is the nervous intermedius? As you all know, the facial nerve, the seventh cranial nerve, has two type of fibers, the motor fibers and the sensory fibers. The sensory root of the facial nerve is called the nervous intermedius. The nervous intermedius, then these fibers enter the main facial nerve, the main trunk of the facial nerve. This is all written in your book, you can remember it from there. Facial nerve, then there is the caudal tympani branch of the facial nerve. Now there is an anatomical relationship between the caudal tympani branch and the greater petrosal nerve, which needs to be clarified. Let's clarify here. Let's suppose this is the medial wall of the tympanic cavity, medial wall of the middle ear cavity. As you all know, the facial nerve along with the vestibulocochlear nerve comes through the internal acoustic meatus and traverse the medial wall of the tympanic cavity like this, and then it enters the lateral wall. I have not drawn the lateral wall here, so you can imagine that the facial nerve will travel like this here at right angle to here. Now, before entering the tympanic cavity, it gives a branch which is called the greater petrosal nerve. This greater petrosal nerve supplies the skeletomotor fibers to the pterygopalatine ganglion, and in this way it supplies the lacrimal gland. You have to remember this, and you have to differentiate between the greater petrosal nerve and the caudal tympani nerve. Caudal tympani nerve, it is given off in the lateral wall of the tympanic cavity, so the caudal tympani nerve will traverse like this through the tympanic cavity. This caudal tympani nerve will then join the lingual nerve, which is a branch of the mandibular nerve in the infratemporal fossa, just before entering the tongue. Lingual nerve supplies the sensory supply to the tongue, and here the special visceral afferent supply also enters the lingual nerve. From the lingual nerve, the fibers relay to the submandibular ganglion. Here the postganglionic fibers enter the submandibular and sublingual salivary gland. Submandibular glands. This is the skeletomotor supply. A lot of students get confused between the greater petrosal nerve and the caudal tympani nerve, because both of them are the branches of the facial nerve. Now the sympathetic supply. Sympathetic supply is very easy. Sympathetic supply almost always comes from the plexus around some artery. Now the artery which is related to the submandibular gland is the facial artery. So obviously the sympathetic supply will come from the plexus around the facial artery. Sympathetic plexus, which comes from the superior cervical ganglion, plexus around the facial artery. But these fibers, as these are the postganglionic fibers, they will not relay here and they will supply the vasomotor supply to the submandibular and sublingual salivary glands. Now the sensory supply of the submandibular ganglion. The sensory supply of the submandibular ganglion comes from the lingual nerve, which is a nerve which is closely related to the submandibular ganglion, and these fibers also do not relay here. They just pass through the ganglion and they just support the ganglion. There is a separate video on my channel about the OT ganglion. You can check it out. Thank you.